In September 93, I was on the Hogan stand for that great All-Ireland final, and the football sure was grand. Billy Morgan and the Cork men, they served up such gallant play, but they failed to match the Derry men who went on to win the day. And as the crowd was filing out in thousands on the street, I saw an old and grey-haired man remaining in his seat. And as I passed beside him, I could see to my surprise that as he gazed around the park, the tears welled in his eyes. I sat right down beside him and I asked if he was well. The old man shrugged his shoulders and he then began to tell how memories come flooding back when I see such great displays, and I picture many former stars who excelled in other days. For more than 50 golden years I've gone to many games. I remember famous matches and the legendary names. And I thank the Lord who spared me, for 'twas always my desire to see the men from Derry taking home the Sam Maguire. Look over there, young fella, do you see that mighty crane? It tells me that our dear Croke Park will never be the same. They start tomorrow morning to take down the Cusick stand. It will never more re-echo the Artane Boys' famous band. I suppose they call it progress because nothing can stand still, and I wouldn't be surprised to see a roof across the hill. But still, I'll hardly see it, for what time I've left is brief. So I'll just retain the memories of the triumphs and the grief. I remember well the 40s when Roscommon bold and true were led by Jimmy Murray with their saffron and their blue. When they played the mighty kingdom and they matched them man for man, I can still see Jig O'Connor, Paddy Bourne and Joe Cohan. I was here in 1945 when the Cork men came and won, with Jack Lynch and Wishy Murphy, Jimmy Cronin, Eamon Young. And I well recall the cabin men who were captained by John Joe, Simon Dagnan and Mick Higgins, Gunnar Brady and Owen Rowe. I was here in 1951 when Mayo defeated Meath, with the tension and excitement sure a man could hardly breathe. 'Twas the era of the great fullback, and no better could you find than the fearless Paddy Prendergast and Paddy Hans O'Brien. Sean Flanagan was brilliant, Pádraig Kearney was supreme, and you couldn't stop Tom Langan when he donned the red and green. Paddy Meegan was a flyer, Frankie Byrne was hard to stop, and the man who took some watching was McDermott with the cap. But perhaps the greatest influence on the football game I knew was the famous 50s football team, the Dublin Boys in Blue. Still, the Kerry men could match them and were never known to yield when the famous Mick O'Connell reigned supreme at centre field. With Sean Murphy, Kevin Coffey and O'Dwyer firmly set, and with Johnny Cullerty in goal, it was hard to find the net. But the 57 winners were the loud men, brave and fine, and the captain of the champions was a clubman named O'Brien. September 1960 saw the kingdom lose their crown. They were beaten well on double scores by the mighty men of Down. A goal from James McCartan set the Down men's hearts on fire. When it went across the border, it was a first for Sam Maguire. The next year they played awfully with Mick Casey and Greg Hughes, and the captain Willie Nolan. What excitement they infused. But the Down men won it by a point, and champions did remain, when more than 90,000 fans were present for that game. And Galway in the 50s I can still remember best, Jack Mahon and Mick Greeley, Frankie Stockwell and the rest. And the greatest football genius I have ever seen by far, yes, it had to be Sean Purser, that magnificent Tuam star. And Galway in the 60s were a treat for all the fans, the Donnellans and the Keenans, and Noel Tierney had great hands. If you ask me what's the greatest team, I'd really have to say it was Kerry in the 80s with Pat Spillane and Jack O'Shea. It's very strange, the old man said, how all these memories last. I remember 50 years ago but forget the recent past. But I'm thinking of the other greats, real heroes in their day, who never won a title after years of brilliant play. Kevin Armstrong from Antrim, Eddie Devlin from Tyrone, with the stalwart Frank McGuigan and the brilliant Iggy Jones, Bill Goodison from Wexford, Bill McCurry from Armagh, and the fair-haired Willie Casey from the town of Ballina. Roscommon had O'Malley, what a credit to the game, and then came Dermot Early, another famous name. There was Sligo's Mickey Cairns, Barnes Murphy, Nace O'Dowd, and in Wicklow, Gerry O'Reilly and Jim Rogers did them proud. I remember Andy Phillips too, who never dropped the ball, and the famous Neely Gallagher, the pride of Donegal. Bill Delaney and his brothers, they were leashmen of renown, and the boy wonder Tommy Murphy from old Great Cullen Town. I remember famous Lily Whites, Pa Connolly, Tom Carew. I remember Ollie Crinigan, he was a good one too. There was Corkman Eric Ryan and Mick Carley from Westmead, who with Cavan's Jim McDonnell had such power, skill and speed. Let's not forget the Leitrim men, the stalwart Cahill Flynn, and the likes of Paddy McGarty we may never see again. There was Derry's Jim McKeever, and Sean O'Connell knew no fear, but they never got a hand on Sam, though they starred for many a year. Well, the crowd was still departing, so we both got up to go. The old man took me by the hand and he said, I'm sure you know, there's one I haven't mentioned yet, the greatest of the Gael. No words can do him justice, superlatives all fail. His majestic contribution to the games we loved so dear, since August 1938 we acknowledge and revere. He filled our homes with atmosphere, his talent was so rare. He's that great, great commentator, our beloved Micheál O'Hare.